Welcome, everyone. It's time to go wild. It's the Time to Go Wild radio show on Halton Community Radio 92.3 FM. We are also live across the world on hcr923fm.com/listen via TuneIn and via smart speakers. If you want to contact the show, please do so. Facebook or twitter.com/ttgwradio. If you want to drop us an email, do so radio@witnesswild.co.uk. Drop us a call 01928 835291 or text 60066. Start your message with HCR. Messages charged at your standard network rate. That time of the week. It's time to go wild. Evening, everyone. Welcome. It's the Time to Go Wild radio show live on HCR 92.3 FM. Oh, what a weekend it's been. No Waikiki Witness World home game, though they were on the road. We've had junior hockey and we've had National League hockey out of Planet Ice Widnes this week. So it's not been a dull weekend. And I have two people all ready to restrain me in my straitjacket and keep me under control. Ah, ever so reliable, Mr. Andy Witchley. Good evening, Andy.
Evening, mate. Completely redundant this week. I've not seen any hockey, so
I'm
just a chauffeur to our guest tonight.
Oh, no, but you can definitely talk about some of the antics of over the season as well. You have plenty of insight to dig into.
I've been once or twice. We should be okay.
Yeah. And sat next to him is a young lass who's likes a little bit of hockey as well. Shannon Holt, welcome, Shannon.
Hello, good evening.
So, yes, you like a little bit of hockey, and then you've kind of got the bug as well now, haven't you?
Yeah, a little bit. You know, got the bug to come and watch, and then came along and started to learn how to play. So, no, absolutely loving it. It's great.
So, yes, we have an extra insight, and you were in attendance last night for the National League game, as I was.
Yeah.
So we should chat about that in a little while, but first, our usual little depth into the results over the last week. Time for your weekly roundup of the results from around the country. Starting on Saturday with Elite Ice Hockey League Challenge Cup action. Coventry Blaze 4, Guildford Flames 5 after a shootout. Elite League action starting on Saturday. Nottingham Panthers 4, Belfast Giants 1, Glasgow Clan 5, Fife Flyers 2, Dundee Stars 4, Manchester Storm 3, Cardiff Devils 4, Sheffield Steelers 3. On Sunday, Nottingham Panthers 2, Belfast Giants 0, Coventry Blaze 9, Glasgow Clan 2, Fife Flyers 1, Dundee Stars 3, Manchester Storm 4, Sheffield Steelers 3, Guildford Flames 3, Cardiff Devils 1. EIHA Under 18s North 2 action from Saturday. Manchester 10, Sutton 5, Solihull 5, Sheffield 4, Widnes 5, Nottingham 6. EIHA Under 15s North 3 action from Saturday. Deeside 9, Solihull 5. EIHA Under 13s North 3 action from Saturday. Deeside 1, Manchester 12. EIHA Under 11s North 3 action from Saturday. Widnes 0, Manchester 9. EIHA Women's Division 1 North action from Saturday. Grimsby Wolves 0, Solway Sharks Ladies 5. Sheffield Shadows 13, Nottingham Vipers 0. NIHL National League action from Saturday. Raiders 3, Sheffield Steel Dogs 5. Hull Pirates 6, Leeds Chiefs 2, Swindon Wildcats 8, Peterborough Phantoms, 5. Basingstoke Bison, 5. Telford Tigers, 4. After overtime. Milton Keynes Lightning, 7. Bracknell Bees, 2. On Sunday, Sheffield Steel Dogs, 1. Milton Keynes Lightning, 3. Leeds Chiefs, 1. Swindon Wildcats, 4. Peterborough Phantoms, 10. Raiders, 1. Bracknell Bees, 2. Basingstoke Bison, 3. Telford Tigers, 5. Hull Pirates, 3. NIHL Division 1 North Morley action from Sunday. Blackburn Hawks, D1, 5. Solway Sharks, 9. NIHL Division 2 North Laidler action from Saturday. Bradford Bulldogs, 6. Altrincham Aces, 3. Telford Tigers, D2, 10. Dragons, 4. Sheffield Senators, 2. Hull Jets, 5. On Sunday, Hull Jets, 2. Bradford Bulldogs, 1. After overtime. An NIHL Midland Cup action from Sunday. Solihull Barons, 7. Sutton Sting, 5. Nottingham Lions, 6. Widnes Wild, 5. After a shootout. And that's a roundup of the scores from over the last week. Of course, we'll have more for you next week here on Time to Go Wild Radio. So come back more for more next week. Oh, some big results in the over the fixtures from the last weekend, and I think we'll start with last night's result. Nottingham 6, Widnes 5 after a shootout. Yet again, the game goes right down to the wire. And considering a major consideration in that game, if I find the game sheet, which is on a different page to the one I've got up, there were 2 goals down in the first couple of minutes. We have a game sheet. Here we go. Yep. 2:38 and 3:27. Nottingham scored, put Widnes on the back foot, and then they started to claw it back. That's quite a bit of a cold start for the guys, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I caught a little bit of the live feed. Did you manage to catch any of the live feed last night?
I caught the last bit of the third period, and then I caught the overtime and the penalty shootout, but that's about as much as I could get last night.
Mm.
Yeah, I managed to watch a little bit of it. But yeah, again, slow start.
Yeah.
It was the same again when played Solihull and last week as well.
Yeah, against Aces, it was a slow out the blocks. But, I mean, Nottingham, it is big ice. That rink is much bigger ice than our pad. And they came out flying. But hat-trick hero for the Widnes Wild this weekend, our very own Sean Dipnell. I mean, the statistics there. I mean, Sean with 3 goals, Danny Bullock with a goal, MJ Clancy with a goal. You know, they managed to spread it around. Tom Jackson with an assist, Matt Tarpey with an assist, Hadji with 3 assists. So, Tarpey managed to get himself a 2+, must have gotten 2+, yeah, 2+10 for boarding. In terms of penalty minutes, it was pretty even as well, that game. So,
Because I think was it the first goal or the second goal? That was on the power play as well.
Yeah, their first goal was both teams' first goals are power plays. So, in terms of the performance, I think the guys, particularly because it was a late start and the bench has been shortened a little bit, we're missing a number of key players. They've dug deep and put the lines back together somehow and pulled something out of it. And it's a point on the board.
It's a point on the board. I don't think many people would have thought we'd get a point. But it's just so frustrating that, you know, Nottingham, it's one of the games that you really target for points.
Yeah.
And they went so short-benched.
Yeah, it's tight. But fair credit, isn't it, really?
Yeah, saying that we was on a short bench, though, I think we really delivered. Especially we're getting, like, the 5 goals against the 5. So I think we did really well, like you said, against the short bench.
Yeah, the guys who were there, absolute full credit to them.
Yeah. mean, you know, you're playing a team that's used to playing the higher level, and in terms of all right, I'm going to stick my head on the chopping block because I was listening to, and watching and listening the end of it, the live feed, and a comment was mentioned about it was the first win at home since Nottingham had played Deeside, and it's like, yeah, played Deeside, and the level that Widnes Wild are at and Nottingham Lions are at, you're taking them to the wire. That's pretty tight, I'd say.
And they've done that to teams all season in this cup.
Yeah.
They've not been pushed over, but, you know, Nottingham, they're taking any opportunity, they're celebrating like they've won the league.
Yeah. let's just have a quick look at the cup results so far. So we've had 1-6 result in favour of Blackburn Hawks, 2-3 loss to Nottingham, 3-9 against Solihull.
That one was a lot closer than that as well.
And yeah, 1-3 against Sutton Sting.
And again, that was last minute.
That was so tight against Sutton. And there's a comment you said about from one of the Sutton players about it's just a bit of polish, really, that they said the Wild are missing.
Yeah, so Mr. Pyatt was saying a couple of changes maybe, or, you know, if we can bring someone else in. He said there's not a lot of difference between Wild at the minute and D1.
Yeah. So, I mean, people, and I've been speaking to people around and about, and some of the people who turned up from the Wild fan base to watch the Leeds Chiefs Swindon Wildcats game last night, and they were saying about how do we feel about A, B and C, and it's a case of what we have to remember this year is there's been significant changes on the top line, and it's a case of two players have retired who are big point scorers. The next line is stepping up and putting the points in, but having to regel the rest of the team and other parts of the team, and it takes time. I mean, Shannon, you know, you're involved in hockey basics. I mean, you're aware of just the skill level required to skate and move a puck from what level you were at when you started getting involved.
Yeah, I mean, it's not easy. It's not an easy sport to get involved in. It's a lot of time and a lot of practice. And I think you watch it from a certain angle and you go, oh, yeah, that looks dead easy. You know, why can't they do X, Y and Z? But actually getting on and doing it is a whole different ballgame.
Hmm. I mean, we've seen. I said comments about the Widnes Wild women, and the fact that last year a lot, you know, a good half of the team were new to playing, not just new to the level, but new to playing hockey.
Yeah.
And Andy and I also experienced it being alongside the blind ice hockey people. You get out there, and it's one thing to just being able to skate and just hold the stick and skate around, but then when you're trying to move a puck as well. That's another different thing.
Yeah.
Add on to that somebody bailing down on you. You know, I mean, you have little scrims and stuff during basics. How does it feel?
Yeah, no, it's a good feeling. It is difficult. Like I said, it's difficult to, you know, move around with the puck, and it's difficult to, you know, to remember to skate and move your feet and, you know, do all these other things, as well as remembering to pass to your teammates, watch where they are. You know, it's not just as easy as, you know, going along with a puck and scoring. It's all about working with your teammates and talking to them as well, as a massive factor.
Hmm. And the thinking time involved. Just at basics, you must come off mentally shattered.
Yeah, you are, definitely. It's really exhausting.
But, you know, invigorating.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
I mean, you see how busy it is at basics. Everyone just seems to have an absolute ball.
Yeah, we love it. We wouldn't play the sport if we didn't love it. Mm.
And so, you know, you translate that level of concentration, the more you now understand it, to what the guys are going through and how quickly, just at D2 level, they have to react. Now let's translate that up to the speed of National League hockey that we were watching last night and how much faster that was.
Yeah, it was really quick. Really quick game last night.
Mm. Very clean.
Very clean, surprisingly, yeah.
Yes. There was myself on one sin bin and Mark Gillingham on the other, and was stood there during the first period going, I don't think anyone wants to come and see us and raid the Haribo stash.
I was going
to
say, how was
the jelly sweets are available.
So as long as the suite situation was okay.
Oh, yeah. It was there, but, you know, it's a case of nobody's realised the sweeties available and they're not coming in.
Just going back to your point of how fast it was, I remember, and this is slightly off, but on topic, if you know what I mean, and there used to be a programme on it, it was Physics Sport, and they actually did a breakdown of ice hockey one week.
Oh, wow.
And they were using NHL,
yeah,
to be absolutely honest, but they were showing the breakdown of what a player's looking at, to the angle of what he's looking at, to where he's got to put the puck, to cross to the teammate, to get the chance to take the shot. And they were basically working on absolute degrees of accuracy, so 2-3 degrees is what they were aiming at.
Yeah.
And it was points of seconds.
Yeah. Oh,
point
yeah.
2.3 seconds is what they had to make the decision with it.
I was watching some action from Tampa Bay Lightning on TV, and you're watching the speed these guys are skating around. Of course, in the National Hockey League, they've made the attacking zones bigger and the centre neutral ice smaller, so it's not straight thirds anymore. But, you know, so yes, when they get into the zone, they've got a bit more space to move now. But the, you know, as you're saying, the reaction times, the mental awareness, the speed of everything that goes on, you must, when you watch a game now, have that better understanding, Shannon?
Yeah, definitely. I totally agree. I mean, watching the guys, you learn a lot from watching them. And, you know, like with this, like you said, with the speed and even just watching them, you know, seeing how they move. And, like, I saw tactical around each other and, you know, really do put on a performance. It's really good. I think the guys are doing really well.
You know, and again, D2 hockey, what we want everyone to remember is these guys work or go to uni or college and stuff during the day, during the week, and then they come and play hockey at a weekend. You know, physical fitness through the roof, or across the entirety of the EIHA leagues, to be honest. It's just remarkable what these guys go through every week at whichever sport, whichever team, men's, women's, across all of them. Credit, absolute credit, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, absolutely, and especially when you consider, yeah, it was Nottingham Sunday night when we were talking about our short bench before. You know, a lot of these guys have uni, have work the next day, so it does happen.
And it was a half seven face-off.
Yeah, so I don't even want to think what time the guys got back last night.
I was chatting to Sam Anderson on Saturday night after the 18s game. Or was it before or after the 18s game? And he said he was travelling. I was like, what time do you expect to get back? He went sort of like, 2:30 or something like that. I went, yeah. And because, of course, the game was on after the Nottingham Panthers game on pad one, the big pad. Thinking, if that goes to overtime and penalty shots, they will delay the other face-off, surely for logistical reasons. Because, of course, they've got that many people in the National Ice Centre. Thinking, oh, crumbs. You know, you don't want to be able to travel all the way back here. I mean, it is a fair trek. From here anyway. I mean, some places it's not so bad. But bus legs can play. I think that was part of it. We had bus legs to start the game. But credit where credit's due. They pulled out that shootout loss. And the table actually makes very nice reading, I would say.
Yeah, well, especially now as we're on the board.
Yeah, there's no duck egg.
You know, they've managed to wipe that out. No one can say that they didn't go in. And as we were discussing before, the goal difference is quite interesting.
Oh, yes. Should quickly mention the goal difference in the cup. Because our goal difference, if my numbers are correct on my my table. Just bear with me 1 minute, dear listener. Where are we? Witness. Yeah, 7:21, 9:39.
Quick maths, always good, mate.
I think we're looking all right there.
So, yeah, like you said, we've got minus 15 goal difference, Nottingham Lions minus 25. And as well, if you actually look at the goals for, we've only scored 3 less than Nottingham, and we've played a game less.
My table's got a mistake in it. I think we're doing better than I thought we were.
Are we?
Yeah. Goals for, I've got Nottingham down at 15, but the league table's got them down at 9. That's interesting.
It's not got the last game on it.
Mustn't have. Oh, it hasn't. It hasn't. You're correct. Very well spotted there, sir. Yeah, I've actually done the additional We're mathematics ahead. On the table. So, yeah, you know, so minus 15 versus minus 25. Next is the Blackburn Hawks on minus 7. I think that's... we've still got some games to play. We're doing all right. I'd say, you know, and moreover, everybody, consider it this way. This is a way in which genuinely, unlike the previous time we played the D1 clubs in the cup, this one is genuinely testing the waters, making sure we understand what's needed to take that step to be genuinely competitive week after week against the teams that are established in D1. That, to me, and hopefully everyone, that's the key thing to take out of this. You know, it's a very, very important thing for everyone to understand, and the players are learning from it.
We just need some league games now.
Yeah. Before we go into that, I think a little bit of a breather. Should we have Jet or Ash? What do you want?
Oh, I would always go with Jet.
You want Jet? Bit of Jet?
Yeah.
Ah, bit of Jet. Ah, are you going to be my girl? And we're at that point in the show where, of course, I do our general reminders of all of our social media and sponsors. If you want to keep an eye on everything to do with your YKK Widnes Wild, check out widneswild.co.uk for the main website. If you want Facebook or Twitter, it's Facebook or Twitter.com/WidnesWild for the club, or TTGW Radio if you want the radio show. You can drop the radio show emails throughout the week, radio@widneswild.co.uk. Our Instagram account is instagram.com/WidnesWildOfficial. That's WidnesWildOfficial. And our YouTube page, youtube.com/WidnesWildIceHockeyClub. Sorry it's so long, but that's what they've let us have. It's so youtube.com/WidnesWildIceHockeyClub. That's where you find all the podcasts and links to all the highlights from our main games. If you want to get an own and loan shirt, check out the website. If there's a link through the fan zone section where you can see all the details about the own and loans. They are £80 for a main game, that's a home or an away shirt to be an own and loanee, or £60 if you want one of the warm-up shirts. There's not many left, but they'll make a nice Christmas present for somebody. We also have details on tickets as well. And we may actually have some details about the next coach trip, but we should check those for you as we go through the show. Finally, we've got our sponsor information, our valued sponsors, of course. YKK, our headline sponsor, the Sepsis Trust, who sponsor our penalty box, and among our other sponsors we have Sprakes and Son of Widnes, DMH Tyres, CL Woodworking, Blast and Paint Stripping, Bespoke Conversions of Widnes, and our charity, that's Stick and Step. Right, here you go, Shannon, your time to shine. What's coming up in the fixtures?
Well, we've got quite a few. So we've got three games on Saturday the 16th of November. The Wild Women are away at Telford Wrecking Raiders. The face-off is at 6:20. You've also got Widnes away at Bradford Under-11s as well. That's at 4:10. And at home on that weekend, you've got Widnes Under-13s versus Deeside Under-13s at 6:15. You've got two games on the Sunday the 17th of November. Widnes Under-15s are away at Solihull Under-15s, and that's at 5:30. And at home, you've actually got the YKK Widnes Wild in the league game against Telford Tigers. That's at 5:30. You've got the Saturday 23rd of November, the Widnes Under-11s is against Billingham Under-11s, and that's at 6:15. On the same day as well, you've got the Under-15s against Deeside Under-15s at 7:45. On Sunday the 24th of November, you've got Widnes Wild in a cup game against Hawks 1, and that's at 5:30. On Saturday the 30th of November, you've got Widnes Wild Under-15s against Deeside, and that's at 6:30. You've got four games on Saturday the 7th of December, so it's a really big weekend. So you've got Widnes under 19s cross ice, which is at Widnes, and that is at 6:15. You've also got Blackburn under 13s against Widnes under 13s at Blackburn, and that's at 4:45. You've got Widnes at Deeside, and that's the under 18s game, which is at 6:30. And then as well on the same day, which is a big one as well, you've got the Wild in the league game against Telford Tigers, and that's at Telford at 7. Also, you've got on Sunday the 8th of December, you've got the Wild at home, which is in a league game against the Deeside Dragons, and that's at 5:30. One of the fixtures has actually been changed for any Wild fans that don't know, who haven't seen the memo. You've got the D2 Hawks versus the Wild. It was originally on the Saturday the 16th of November, but that's now been changed. It's now on Saturday the 29th of February 2020 at 6:15. So there you go.
Ah, so there we go. Yep, thanks for that, Shannon. Brilliant, no worries. Brilliant. So yes, don't forget, everybody, big fixture change this Saturday. The game in Blackburn is not happening. It will be taking place on the 29th of February. I think part of the reason is a bit of a logistics battle, because I think Leeds Chiefs are playing out of Blackburn that day as well. And it, having two fairly big teams playing out of the rink would be a bit of a nightmare, to be honest. It's hectic enough when you've got under 11s and under 18s playing on the same day, or an under 13s and an under 18s game on the same day, one after the other. So it can get a bit hectic. So a big thank you to everyone who's managed to rearrange that one and get the information out as quickly as possible. So let your friends know, this Saturday the Wild are not in Blackburn. It's going to be the 29th of February. So, big shout out to our junior teams for this last weekend, because we had under 11s action against Manchester and then an under 18s game against Nottingham. And our 11s, I've got to give extra credit to, because a lot of them came through from Altrincham after having played a cross ice tournament in Altrincham on Saturday afternoon. They were literally skate guards on in the car down the motorway to Planet Ice Widnes, back, walked in full kit. One of them was the goaltender, Mix. He came in his kit, straight onto the ice to warm up to play an 11s game, which is played with running clock as well. How about that?
I mean, fair play. I can't even drive home after a game at Altrincham and just watching. I just get on the couch and run asleep.
Just think of the level of fitness those kids have. Yes. Or the amount of sugar they burn off. Oh, if only. So, you know, fair credit to every single one of those kids who's done that. And it was a good, entertaining game, and it was kept in the right spirits. We did have to call the mercy rule, but Manchester's 11s team, really well drilled, good team, well experienced. But the exciting one, to really give us a seat of our pants game, was the 18s game against Nottingham. That was brilliant. Full credit to both teams, played really well. And experience to experience on a set of scales, anybody out there, guys, think about it. Nottingham's junior system's been around a long time. Who would you have predicted a win? Who would you?
Yeah, you're always going to say Nottingham, aren't you?
Yeah. Shannon?
Yeah.
And would you have predicted a close game or quite a big score for Nottingham?
It's a decent gap.
Yeah. Didn't happen. As you heard in the results, it was a wee bit tighter than that. One goal in it. And, yeah. When it's 5-5 going into the final minute of the, as you're heading into the final minute of the game, and the Nottingham under-18s managed to draw a penalty on Widnes. So there they are on the power play, bing, bing, bang, gutted. But every single one of the players could hold their head high and say they'd given as much as they could, because they came back into the game and kept it tight.
It's going to be an interesting year or two for Wild, because there's some good players in that.
Yeah.
In that under-18s.
Yeah, it's going to take, I mean, because of where they are in their age, if they can just keep building and keep building. And again, our 13s have been doing well this year. So, you know, the way the 11s are sort of starting off new, the 13s and 15s have had a year, the 18s is new, that's going to continually build through. So, you know, in terms of the academy, it's wonderful seeing all the amount of effort that everyone's putting in week in, week out. And, of course, we've got some academy fixtures this weekend. The party animals, as I nickname them, are in action this weekend. The Wild Academy under-13s, 6:15. Come along. They're a gang of absolute nutters.
Is this your YMCA crew?
This is the gang where they dance in the stands, on the benches, and on the ice. Both teams. I'm not joking. It's hilarious. Honestly, the 13s, from all the teams, they're just crazy. So come down, give them some support. They are really good games, good to watch, and the kids really, really appreciate the support. They really do. As for you, Shannon, the amount you got the bug to play hockey.
Yeah.
How?
I originally started watching Manchester Phoenix. That shows how old I am. about when I was 12 or 13, and I remember going along to the games, and I was like, oh, this is amazing. And obviously they folded, and then I decided that, you know, I'm going to come to Widnes. So I came along and watched the lads, and I thought, do you know what, I bet you I could give this a go. So I thought, oh, I'll get on the ice and see how it turned out. And then turned out like Bambi, couldn't skate for nothing. And then I had Terry teach me. And year and a half later, and I think I'm doing all right. Everybody tells me I'm doing all right. You know, going along to the Wild Women's training, and you know, really getting on the ice and pushing myself, and you know, I'm really enjoying myself. It's really good.
I mean, in terms of the Wild Women, you mean you've got to know the squad.
Yeah.
So you know who joined and was actually playing league action last year for the very first time, and their experiences from it, and you can see how everything's sort of building this year now that they're in the Division 1, and the speed and all the reactions, and as you're saying about the reaction times on the ice when you're playing. I mean, the difference between hockey basics and you know, training and the scrim with the girls' team, how does that differ?
So basics, you learn a lot more about how to skate. You learn a lot more about how to play the game. It's not necessarily about, you know, doing the drills and getting the drill right. It's more about getting your technique right. And that's why I still go along on a Sunday, because I think it's really beneficial. With the ladies, it's so intense. It's so fast paced. It's a lot more drill work, but it's a lot about getting to know the actual game and how to play the game when you're on the ice as well. So it's vastly different. You know, it's a lot quicker, and you are moving your feet a lot more, and you do come off and you're like, oh, I am tired now, I need to go to bed. But no, it's really good fun. Really good fun.
I mean, you really understand just how much effort, and a lot of people don't understand why hockey's played in shifts. And, you know, it's one thing being on a hockey basics where you're on for the entire session, but then when you're training with a team that are used to playing a shift as well, you know, how have you enhanced your understanding of how that works?
So with the shifts, like with the 1 minute, 2 minute changes, you know, you do need to get that shift work quite quick and quite tight, because if you don't, you are going to be like panting and out of breath for like the next shift. But I think if you make that right in the first instance with the quick shift changes, and you know, you get on and off well with your other teammates, then it's going to work better, it's going to flow better, it's going to make the game better, especially for you and everybody else on the ice.
Mm. Yeah, I mean, the changes can be so quick sometimes.
Yeah.
You get used to a line, and then, of course, if there's injuries or for whatever reason, they change a line up. Hang on a minute. And it can confuse players as well when you're used to playing alongside certain people, and then you've changed your line, and you know, you're doing basics as well, and you work alongside with the women's team. I take it when you're training, you often play and work with a certain regular people, and yeah, then maybe from time to time they'll change who you're working with, and how do you manage to adjust to that?
I mean, because I obviously don't play this year, and I just have like an outtake from playing with the women's effectively. I learn a lot from like working with my line, and I learn that because I don't have a specific line because I can't play this year. I learn that you've got to adapt whatever you can do to whatever everybody else can do. And I think the way you connect with each other, and especially learning about each other as well, and the way you all work, I think that's really good. You do have to adapt yourself when you go back onto basics and go, oh right, okay, like let's slow it down a little bit. But that's all about, again, getting the technique right and making sure that you're doing everything spot on.
What would you say to anyone who's thinking of taking up hockey basics?
Go and do it. Get it done. it's ace. I can't imagine myself not skating now. Like, even if you wanted to just go and do a public skate, you know, you learn so much from it. You learn to balance and all sorts. So, no, it's really good. It's good fun. Get it done.
Once I find my feet, I can just about go forwards. Both. And go on, Andy, say it.
No, I'm not going to say it. Yeah,
he's been giving me stick ever since that session with the blind hockey about
when you pushed an old woman over.
I didn't push her over. She slipped
when you used her for balance.
She fell. I couldn't help her up because my balance is that terrible. But there's a couple of the guys. I'll name drop Howard Smith into it because you see his postings online, and next thing he's of scrim anyone. It's like, you know, he is a complete addict.
Yeah, he loves it. Absolutely loves it. But do you know what? He's come on leaps and bounds in the past, I'd even say like 6 months. Like, I've not known Howard for very long, but for what I have known him, I've seen him really progress. But he does put his heart and soul into it every time he's on the ice. Mm. He's not going half-hearted at all. You know, he's enjoying himself.
Mm. I'm seeing all the faces who are there week in, week out for hockey basics after the games on a Sunday night. I mean, you're all there because you want to be there. You're not being pushed into it.
No, we love it. We absolutely love it. It's a good fun. It's a good laugh.
Right. Time for a little bit of the news. Yes, our weekly roundup of a few news items from around the hockey world. A big one that's been happening at the moment, courtesy of Ice Hockey UK, the GB Under-18s Women's have been in action recently with some big results. One of the biggest ones was they beat Poland Under-18s Women by 4-2 recently. So big shout out for them. All the results that they've had within this competition they've been involved with, this is all under 18s, as I must say. So there was Spain 0, Great Britain 3, Iceland 1, Poland 7, Spain 3, Poland 4 after a shootout, Great Britain 4, Iceland 3, Spain 6, Iceland 5, Poland 2, Great Britain 4. So, you know, some big results, and congratulations to the under-18s for that form, wouldn't you say, guys?
That's a massive result.
That's absolutely brilliant. So, great form there. Where are we? We have big news in the women's game. The headline reads, something that hasn't happened for over 900 days happened in the WNIHL Women's Ice Hockey League in the Elite. The winning streak by the Bracknell Queen Bees has finally been broken. And it was broken by the Solihull Vixens, who defeated them by 5-4. And it was Katie Henry's last-minute goal that secured the win. And a name from a few of us might recognise, Sarah Hutchinson, plays for the Solihull Vixens, ex-Altrincham Aces.
She was at the game last week as well.
Yes, she was. Yes, she was at the Aces game, because of course her dad's still involved with the Aces. So yes, that is a massive result. Queen Bees have been had an unbroken run for 931 days. That's a lot of games.
But what an achievement, though, for them. Like, oh, yeah. That's amazing. Like, that is proper hockey at its finest. Yeah.
Do we know what Solihull's record was in D2 when they were in?
Not sure.
Surely that's got to eclipse it or be close.
I think it's pretty close. It's just pretty close. Of course, the other big one in the fixtures that was released by the EIHA is we now know the venues for the D2 North and D2 South finals weekends. The Wilkinson final for D2 South will be held at Alexandra Palace the weekend of the 4th and 5th of April, and the D2 North Laidler finals will be held for the third year in a row at Planet Ice Widnes. 4th and 5th of April, so get the dates, get the hotel bookings ready, and get ready to party at Planet Ice Widnes for the D2 North Finals.
Just means our match night volunteers have got another busy weekend at the
very
end of the
busy.
Season.
Very
yes,
busy.
Yes, we have. Yeah, yet again. No sleep for the wicked. But we know what to expect, so we're feeling a bit sort of seasoned to it now, I think.
It's going to be a good weekend, though.
Yeah, it should be. No matter who's involved, that should be an absolutely cracking weekend of hockey. Now, who's been on the naughty step?
Quite a few people at the minute.
Yeah. Yes, that music means a trek to the good, the bad and the ugly. Andy, start us off.
Yep, so Nottingham Lions' Ben Wilson's picked up a match for physical abuse of an official in the NAHL Midland Cup game v Sutton and suspended for 10 games with 5 penalty points.
Ouch!
Solent Devils duo Alex Cole and Daniel Shear received a match for fighting in the South 1 game v Raiders. Both incidents were multiple punches against an unwilling combatant, and each player is suspended for 6 games with 5 penalty points.
Ooh.
So, I mean, that's just cruel.
That's brutal.
Yeah.
Speaking of brutal, Cardiff Fire Josh Haslam was assessed for a match for slashing in the South 1 game v Milton Keynes. Cardiff requested a review of the penalty, and the match penalty was upheld under Rule 1596, I think that is. A player who lifts his stick between an opponent's legs for the purpose of contacting the groin... Yep, everyone wins. Will be assessed with a 5+ game or match penalty. Haslam is suspended for 3 games with 5 penalty points. And finally, yeah, Bracknell Bees forward Vanya Anatov received a match for abuse of an official in the NIHL game against Raiders. Bracknell requested a review of the penalty, and after reviewing the incident, the match penalty has been downgraded to a game misconduct and there is no automatic suspension to be served. All I'm going to say is, sitting in the penalty box every week, there's a lot of abusive officials here.
Yeah, there is. There is.
It's the one that's brought tears to my eyes of ringing the chapel bells. Oh, I've seen it tried. I've seen it work a couple of times. Who is it they got? Somebody, they got one. Who was it they got? Pav? Someone got Pav.
Oh, right, I don't remember that one.
That was when he went and absolutely levelled somebody because they went and rang the chapel bells.
Yeah, because it's unusual for Pav to have gone.
Yeah, yeah. The other year, Pavel Valas had a big coming together with somebody. And we're like, why is Pav fighting? And then we realised why. And, yeah, listener, my eyes are actually watering, genuinely watering at the thought of somebody... Oh, dear. Ouch. So that's our roundup of the good, who's been good, who's been bad, and who's been a goalie for the last week. Oh, some. I mean, the fight with the, what was it, the opponent, the unwilling combatant. You can definitely say the two combatants the other week in the YKK Widnes Wild v Altrincham Maces were willing combatants for that one, weren't they,
oh,
kids?
Absolutely.
That was definitely willing. And it was nice yeah. to see an old school start to a
yeah.
fight.
Oh, that was, yeah. You could, and it was nice to see the officials go, we know this is coming. We're going to let it go.
It
yeah.
kind of gave it away when Kemp went forward. We was like, right, something's going down.
Yeah, Kempy lining up on a forward line on the yeah. wing. It's like,
something's going to happen.
And I just like, and I know it's not often we do this, but fair play to Bain because he was yeah. not meant to be in that fight, but he wouldn't let who was go up against Kempy.
Yeah.
So he stepped up to go in against someone twice his size.
Oh, yeah, I mean, Lee Kemp off the ice
He's an ace guy.
I'm 6 foot two, and I stand next to Lee Kemp, and I feel like a midget. I genuinely feel I have to crane my neck to talk to Kempy. I was like, he must be about 6'4",
yeah,
5".
Yeah, something like that.
So, poor Toria.
Yeah, definitely.
But, and as you say, off the ice, these guys, they know how to play. But it isn't nice when it's an unwilling combatant. And so, if you are going to get involved in a little bit of fisticuffs, do it properly, please. We want it to be fun and exciting,
stick
not
to
nasty.
The unwritten rules of the game.
Yes, there is a code of conduct. And, we don't want it to turn into a complete and utter circus of slapshot.
And again, I've said it a million times, Ice Guardians, just watch it. Amazing documentary.
I have got to watch that, yeah. I do have to watch Ice Guardians.
I think that's on my Netflix to go.
It was on Netflix.
I think it still is.
I'll have to check.
If you're ever unsure about fighting in hockey, watch that. And it just explains everything.
I think I said as well when you mentioned about Ice Guardians, it's going back a number of years. There was a program, I think it was shown on BBC. It was either BBC Two, Channel 4 or Channel 5. And I was supposed to be travelling from Hull to Liverpool for the weekend. And I ended up watching this program because it was, these guys from the Central Hockey League, the CHL in North America, who were the fighters. And there's one guy and his hand literally was a club. He had to basically he was getting to the point he had to retire because he couldn't hold the stick. He had to tape the sticks. It was so, so bad on his fingers. And you just saw his hand. It was just clubbed up. But these guys would go out there and fight. And in some ways, there were some leagues. I think the LNAH, Quebec League. If they don't have a proper fight in the game, the fans want their money back. Seriously?
Wow.
They expect a proper scrap in a game. But one of the funniest games I've seen for a fisticuffs, this is going back a number of years now, and I've actually got a video of it, Tulsa Oilers against the Wichita Thunder, and they were running goalies. One team was running the goalie.
Yeah.
So in the end, the other team decided to run the other goalie, and it ended up with a big line brawl. And the number of And then they had to stop the first period early, and then they read out all the penalties. And so-and-so, a five-minute major for fighting and a game misconduct. And, of course, in the Central Hockey League, they just have five-minute majors for fighting. And it's like, 2 minutes instigating, a five-minute major for fighting and a game misconduct. And this is going out over the PA. They ended up with they started off with three lines each. One ended up with two lines, and one ended up with a line plus four.
That's like going back to your Disney Goofy one.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're just constantly acting.
Oh, yeah. What's that one? I'm trying to remember the name of it now. But yeah, that hockey game, the hockey madness, when at the end all the fans are on the ice fighting, the players are in the stands.
Yeah.
Class. Well, we're almost out of time for another week, believe it or not. Looking forward to this weekend?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's a busy one. Telford. Big game.
Yeah, that's we need to get back on winning ways on this one.
Yeah, it's very much a big points one to pull something out the hat, because it's time to start building and moving up that table. Just getting the league table up. Oh, I got it here anyway. So at the moment, Telford are in fourth. Wild, seventh, but Telford have played 11 games. Wild have only played 5.
But Telford's always one of them games. It's always going to be tough.
Yeah. It can be very clutch and grab. It can be very skating. You don't find out until we get there. So be loud and proud, everybody. Get yourselves, if you're in the Halton area, get yourselves down to Planet Ice Widnes for Sunday. And also come and get a quick hockey fix on Saturday as well, and give our under-13 some extra support. If you want to go on the road, go down to Telford to see the Wild Women. You know. There's plenty of hockey going on in the area. You never know what there is. Shannon.
Yes.
Highlight of last weekend. Would you say it was a good night on Sunday as well for the National League game?
I can't remember.
It was Leeds Swindon.
Can't think.
It was the Leeds Swindon game on Sunday.
Oh yes, of course it was. it was okay. Can't really go much further than that. First period, I think, was wishy-washy. I think it was a bit Slow.
Leeds started quick. Swindon seemed to take a while to find their feet.
Yeah, the overall play was slow, I thought.
But then it picked up in the second.
Yeah, definitely.
It really picked up. For me, it was nice to bump into some old faces, some friendly faces from the past, both in the fans and in the crowd and some of the players as well. Going to give a big shout out actually to Alison Archer, who's James Archer's mum, who I'd spoken to many years ago. Now it feels like yesterday in some way, but in Hull, and James was actually playing for Peterborough first, and then he was playing for Hull, and now he's playing for Leeds. And it was really nice to sort of say hello. She remembered who it was and having a nice chat. So, and she also presented the MVPs, one of which was James. But other faces on both teams. One player I haven't seen for a long time on the ice, Neil Lydiard, who's with Swindon. So it's a case of crumbs. I haven't seen Lids on the ice for a long time. So it was just nice seeing a lot of different faces, familiar faces in the crowd and on the ice.
Yeah. And I met Luke Boothroyd this weekend.
And Boother, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
He's still his usual smiley self.
Yeah, definitely. It was nice to see him after, you know, watching him when I was younger and then seeing him now and, you know, how much he's developed.
Yeah.
And still that he's such still a nice, genuine guy.
Oh, yeah, so. Yeah. Well, that's it. Time to play out with a bit of Ash Shining Light, I think. Andy, thanks once again.
No problem. Good. Always been in.
And, hobnobbing with royalty of the road, I think you'd say, in some of the people at the weekend, wasn't it?
Yeah, hanging about with Dario Franchitti from IndyCar fame last weekend.
Some of these people. Doesn't come to hockey, goes meeting people like Dario Franchitti. I don't know.
Playing in 100,000 plus race cars. Mm.
And this is why he doesn't come skating.
Absolutely.
Shannon, thank you for coming in.
Thank you for having me. Thank you. Loved it.
Been great. Well, anyway, from me for another week, it's time to sign off. Wherever you are, look after yourselves. Enjoy your hockey for another week. I'll be back on Thursday night from 9 o'clock with Musical Mayhem with the Box of Delight, and then back next Monday with more here on Time to Go Wild Radio. So for another week, take care of yourselves, and ta-ra.